Welcome back to stage three of this mini project. And as a reminder, this is the architecture that you've implemented to this stage of the mini project. You have two environments, AWS on the left and the simulated on-premises environment on the right, and you've successfully configured two VPN tunnels from the on-premises environment to each of endpoint one and two at the AWS side. Now, this infrastructure from a VPN perspective is operational. What we need to do though is configure routing and security groups. So we need to allow the routing to occur from the on-premises environment to AWS and from AWS to the on-premises environment. And in addition to that, we need to configure the security groups within both environments to allow traffic to flow. Now, this is a simulated on-premises environment that we're running, so if this were a real production deployment, then you would more likely be configuring firewall rules on the on-premises firewall. But in this mini project, it's being simulated with AWS, and so we're going to be configuring security groups. Now, to do that, we need to move back to the AWS console. Go to the tab you should still have open to the VPC console. That's where we're going to be performing this configuration. If you don't have one open, then you can right-click on VPC and open that in a new tab. First, we're going to be configuring the AWS side routing. So click on Route Tables under Virtual Private Cloud. Now, there are three route tables created by the one-click deployment: RT-AWS, RT-on-prem-private, and RT-on-prem-public. We're going to start with the AWS side routing. So select RT-AWS. So this is the route table that's attached to both of the subnets within the AWS side infrastructure. And if I click on routes, you'll be able to see the only normal route that we have is the local route for the AWS VPC. So that's 10.16.0.0/16. Now, because we're using a virtual private gateway, we actually have two options on how to configure this routing. We can either edit the routes here and statically add a route for the on-premises IP range pointing at the virtual private gateway. That's one way we could do this. Another way is to use route propagation. So this is a feature of virtual private gateways which allow them to automatically add routes to a route table for any networks that it's aware of. And a network that it's aware of is, of course, the on-premises network range. And that's what we're going to do. So click on Route Propagation. You'll see that Route Propagation is not enabled. So edit Route Propagation. Check the Enable box and note that this is the virtual private gateway that's attached to this VPC and it's used as a termination point for the VPN connection that we created. So make sure it's enabled and click on Save. Now, once done, if we go back to routes, you can see that it now has 192.168.8.0/21, which is the IP range used within the simulated on-premises environment, and it's pointing at the virtual private gateway, and we can see that this has been added as a propagated route. So this has been done automatically. So now any of our AWS side infrastructure knows how to route towards our simulated on-premises environment. So next we need to configure the on-premises side. So click on Route Tables and then select RT-on-prem-private. So it's the private subnet which we want to be able to reach the AWS network over this VPN. And so it's the private route table which is associated to the private subnet that we want to edit. So for this one, click on Routes and then click on Edit Routes. Now, just to reiterate what we're doing, we're editing the route table for the private on-premises network. So what we want to do is any traffic that's destined for AWS, we want to point it at the pfSense firewall. So to do that, click on Add Route, and we need to enter the AWS IP range. And this is 10.16.0.0/16. So go ahead and enter that. And then under target, because this pfSense device has multiple network interfaces, we can't select instance. We need to select network interface. So go ahead and click on network interface. And it will show a list of network interfaces, and we need to pick the on-prem router private ENI. So this is the private network interface of the pfSense firewall. This is the network interface that's within the private subnet. So select on-prem router space private ENI, and then click on save changes. So that's the routing configured, so now both sides know how to reach the other. But it still won't function because we have security groups in the way blocking traffic. So the next step is to edit the security groups at both sides of this architecture, AWS and on-premises. And again, if this were a production deployment, these on-premises security groups would be firewall rules on your on-premises firewall. But because this is being simulated, we'll also be using security groups. So scroll down under security and select security groups. Now there are going to be three named security groups here. Default A4L on-prem SG. So this is the default on-premises security group. Default A4L AWS SG. So this is the default AWS side security group. And then on-prem router SG. So this is a security group that's only associated with the on-premises pfSense router. So first we're going to configure the AWS side security group. So select default A4L AWS SG. Click on inbound rules. And notice how there are no rules for the on-premises network. This is just a self-referential rule. This allows any traffic from instances where this is attached to reach any instances where this is also attached to. So what we need to do is add another rule for the on-premises networks. So let's go ahead and do that. Click on Edit Inbound Rules and then Add Rule. Change this custom TCP to be all traffic. We're going to enter the network range used by the simulated on-premises environment, which is 192.168.8.0/21. So select that. And then we're going to add a description and just put allow on-premises in. And this means we know what this rule represents. Then we can click on save rules. And this will allow anything within the on-premises network range to connect to our AWS infrastructure. In this case, it's AWS Server 1 that we're going to be connecting to, but that's going to occur in the next stage of this mini project. Now we need to configure the on-premises side. First, I want you to go ahead and select default A4L on-prem SG, and we need to allow a rule which allows anything from the AWS side to connect into this security group, because this is securing any of the infrastructure at the on-premises side. So click on inbound rules and then edit inbound rules. We need to add a new rule, change custom TCP to all traffic, and we need to enter the IP range used for the AWS VPC. So this is 10.16.0.0/16. So select that, and then for the comment, put allow AWS in and click on save rules. Now the last thing that we need to do is to edit the security group for the on-premises router. So currently this only has a self-referential rule which allows anything with this security group attached to connect to anything else which also has this security group attached, and it also has a rule allowing TCP port 443 to connect from anywhere, and this is for the web administration. But what it doesn't allow is any other traffic to get in to this security group. Now, because this is acting as a VPN endpoint, we need to allow anything else running on premises to access this router. So we need to add a rule either for the on-premises network range, or alternatively, we can allow connections from the default on-premises security group. Both of those will work. If this were a production deployment, you would need to allow the IP range. So select on-prem router SG and click Edit Inbound Rules, Add Rule, change the drop-down to All Traffic, and then inside this search box, type S2S, and then select S2S VPN hyphen on-prem SG. So this is the default security group used by anything else within the on-premises environment. So select this one. Under description, allow private subnets to use VPN and click on Save Rules. And at this point, you've configured the routing and the security for both sides of the architecture on screen now. Now, the only thing which remains is for us to test whether this VPN functions as expected. And that's something we're going to do in the next stage of this mini project. At this point, that's everything you need to do in this stage of the mini project. So go ahead and complete this video. And when you're ready, I look forward to you joining me in the next stage of this mini project.